spread out in the dash. Running man high, get to the cash. This polo is Gucci, no Lauren. She say I'm too fly, be touring. Wrist looking like I poured it. James Harden, I'm scoring. Riding the two when I head to the bush. Eyes low, I be off for the cuz. BB's on, all I feel is the lugs. Pockets full, shit look like a buck.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another Western Illinois Legacy episode. Today, the 19-8 Leathernecks will take on the 7-20 Mastodons from IPFW in the first round of the Summit League tournament. And that is why we're playing such a poor record team. Frazier, Caldwell, Sykes. Remember Bingo Sykes. We'll have to deal with him today. But there's Rainmaker for three. Going to start us off with the 3-0 lead. And then they would get a nice drive inside by Frazier. But Gonzalez would miss a three there. Fundamentals picking up the garbage, making it a 5-2 game. Then a miss there, but a nice putback for IPFW. They're down a point, and then Fundamentals getting that, and the foul would be 8-4. There's a three, and that one's bouncing all over the place. It'll go in for Rainmaker. Really nice bucket. Here's Fundamentals. He gets that out to Gonzalez, who nails another three. It's 14-6 at this point. Gonzalez left wide open, and you just can't do that. That's another easy three for the Leathernecks. There's a nice drive for IPFW, but they're still down 9 points before Fundamentals is able to get inside for a quick two. Now 19-10, make it 12 with that point from Burrows there. Now Rainmaker going to kick it out to Gonzalez for a lovely shot. 21-12 now. They get a nice drive. Burrows again doing very good work driving into the paint. And then IPFW for a long ranger, making it 21-17. Then inside, it is going to be Big B with his first points of the ball game. And then we've got McKnight from outside. Very nice. Now 26, make it 26-22 now after that lovely shot from IPFW. And now here we are, we're looking, and inside, very nice play there for Sykes from IPFW. It's a 2-point ball game, IPFW with the ball. Good drive, misses the bucket, but gets his own rebound to go. And now here we come off of a pride steal to take the bucket. We will take a 4-point lead, 30-26 into halftime. As you can see, both teams shooting 52%. The difference is we've made more threes. There's Aries McKnight, and he's going to start us off with a three here in the second half. They would turn around, make a two, but then Gonzalez from three, making it a 6-point game. Now passing around, Gonzalez in the middle. Very nice. Usually you don't see him in the post. That's where you see him outside as he makes another huge shot. It's 41-32, now 43-32. It'll be 43-35 before long. And here's Gonzalez again trying to bury the dagger. And he does it right there. It's an 11-point ball game. IPFW, nice ball movement. Really nice ball movement from them. They're 9 points out. Make it 7 after that. Nice little drip by Frazier. But Big B going to get the easy two back. It's going to be 50-41 now. It's a 9-point ball game. Western Illinois trying to close this thing with just over 4 minutes to go. It is Medicine giving them a little Tony Medicine. Now here's Meyer. He's looking. He's going to pass this around. It ends up in Caldwell's hands, then to Frazier's hands, and he will make the bucket there. Frazier's been doing a really nice job off the glass. Then there's a nice shot by Gonzalez from the outside, making this thing a 15-point game in favor of our Leathernecks. McKnight burying the dagger, making it 61-43. And now a nice board right there for McKnight. He would get the putback. 63-43. It's a 20-point game until they would nail a three there, making it a 17. But Gonzalez gets it right back as he's wide open yet again. It's a 72-51 game now. And Gonzalez buries the last dagger. It is 75-51. Leathernecks over the Mastodons. And, of course, Derek Gonzalez will be your player of the game. 30 points. He was 11 of 16 from the floor, 8 of 13 from 3. Also had a rebound, 2 assists, and 3 steals in the ball game. So we know how well he can play. Rainmaker with his 8 points, 4 boards, and 6 assists had a pretty nice full stat line. Aries McKnight with 13, Bigby with 10, 5 boards, 6 assists, and Fundamentals with 11 points, 11 boards, and 6 assists. Nice double-double for him. He had a nice full stat line, 3 blocks for him as well. Tony Medicine came in. He hit that 1-3. He missed 6 shots, 6 threes as well. Frazier was there. One of 2 double-digit scorers, Burrows being the other one. Burrows coming in off the bench for IPFW to get those points. But that is it. We win that one, and our second round opponent will be Southern Utah. We have played them before. That is featuring Rigo's player, Elias Parting. It's going to be a huge game. What do you guys think is going to happen? Let me know your score predictions in the comment section below. And please do not forget to subscribe if you are new and leave a like.